Hi, I'm Laura, and today I'm going to show you how to automate a workflow with Zapier and Creatopy. And if you haven't used Zapier yet, briefly put, Zapier helps you automate workflows and tasks by integrating with over 5,000 apps. For today's use case, I'll go with one of the biggest e-commerce platforms out there, Shopify. So, our objective is to create a template for Shopify based on a design set made in Creatopy. Now, let's jump right in. This is the creative I'll be using today. Pro tip, for optimal results, keep the text length in mind while planning your design. For example, your headline should fit the entire product name. Also, we'd recommend to build your template around your product images from Shopify. Naming the layers I want to change will help in matching them with the right information from Shopify. In our case, I'll be replacing product name, product image, and price. The cool part is that with Zapier and Creatopy, you can set up a trigger and generate a new ad creative when a new product is added to your store. Now that I have a design set ready, I'll go to the API credential page in Creatopy, in the account settings, and generate an API key to use in Zapier. Then we access Zapier to set up the automation. In Zapier, I'll create a new Zap and set up a trigger. New product in Shopify. Zapier works on if-then rules, so we have to create triggers to generate actions. I'll connect my Shopify account to Zapier, and this will offer full access to my store. I'll test the trigger, and if there are no errors, we can continue setting up the action. Here we need to select the Creatopy event in order to generate creatives. Then I'll have to connect my Creatopy account to Zapier, and here I'll use the client ID and API key I've generated earlier. Now that Zapier has access to my Creatopy account, it can find and pull all my designs I have in my team. So we'll select the design we created earlier as a template, set the download format, set file quality, and now we can match the layers we decided to replace: product image, product name, and price. When I'm done, I'll test the action, and I'll get a success message containing a code that I'll need to copy for the next Zap. Make sure you save yours, but in case you don't, you can always find it here in edit mode. At this point, the Zap is finished, and the new creatives are being generated, but I have to decide what to do with them. I could send them to my inbox or to a cloud storage, Google Drive, Dropbox, or even post them live on social media. For this example, I'll add them to my Google Drive. So I'll create a second Zap. And this one will use the Creatopy Creative Generated trigger. Once I connect my account, I need the code saved from the first Zap. This code indicates which creatives to use. Then I test the trigger and get the URL to the newly generated creatives which I want to send to Google Drive. So the action is Google Drive, and then I set up each field. I select my drive, choose a folder. In case you have a banner set, you can select specific sizes to export, or by selecting the last option, you can save your whole set. And last but not least, I choose a file name. Test it, and now let's check the new creatives. And here they are. Now, whenever I add a new product to my store, a new banner set will be generated. All these newly generated banners can be found and edited in Creatopy so I can tweak them if needed. So whether you're zapping out hundreds of designs in one go or setting up triggers for a steady flow of creativity, the possibilities are endless. This is just one of the many ways Creatopy's Zapier integration can help you automate your workflow. But remember, you can replicate and adapt this with a whole range of apps. It's all about making your workflow as dynamic as your imagination. For more Creatopy tutorials, make sure to check out the Creatopy Learning Hub. See you around!